Hey folks, welcome to the end user track of our tutorial videos. We'll be spending some time today taking a quick tour of the OU Campus interface, as well as the crucial first step of logging into the system. If you're new to OU Campus, this will start getting you familiar with some terms that are used throughout the product and in upcoming videos as well. Now, when it comes to logging into the system, OU Campus has a unique feature that's meant to make the process very simple. We call it Direct Edit. Direct Edit is a link that's placed on each one of the pages inside of your site. This link, when it's clicked, will allow you to log into OU Campus and be taken immediately to the same page that you are viewing on the live site, as opposed to being dropped at a central dashboard or in a confusing file structure. This can be a huge time saver. Let's see it in action. I've got my site pulled up here, and say I want to edit some information regarding the price of sporting event tickets. Let me travel to the tickets page on the live site, scroll to the bottom of the page, and then click this last updated link that's here in the footer. For my site, this is what my direct edit link looks like. I get taken to the login screen where I'll enter my credentials, and when that's done here, I will be taken directly to the tickets page inside of OU Campus, so I could go ahead and make any edits that need to be done. Now that we've logged in, I want to take some time to show you around the important parts of the OU Campus interface. There's a lot you can do in the system, which also means that there's a lot of places you can go and screens to view. Hopefully, by the end of this tour, you'll feel a little more comfortable making your way around OU Campus. First of all, let's look at the blue bar that extends across the top of your screen. We call this the global navigation bar, and no matter where we are in the system, the global navigation bar will always be there. This is where you're able to switch between really essential functions in the system. Now, below the global navigation bar is a smaller gray bar that will also always be visible. This is our system-wide breadcrumb, which shows where you are in the system. Right now, it tells me that I'm inside the content area of OU Campus, viewing the pages list view, more on that in a second, and then the file path to the web page that I'm currently viewing. On the other side of the gray bar, over to the right, I can see which site I'm currently viewing. I have multiple sites in my account, so I can choose between them by clicking this drop-down menu. Below the breadcrumb, we have the rest of my screen, which will change depending on where I am in the system. Right now, I'm viewing a single page, so I see the Page Actions toolbar, which consists of all of these icons and buttons, and then, right below that, a preview of my page. We'll talk more about the Page Actions toolbar in subsequent videos, but at a basic level, this toolbar is where you're able to switch between functions for a particular page, such as editing it to viewing past versions, for example. Inside the global navigation bar are several menus that correspond to the main areas of OU Campus. Each menu gives you more options when you hover over them, and the general rule of thumb is that if you click the parent menu item, such as Dashboard here, you'll be taken to the first menu sub-item, which would be Overview in this example. So now let's actually go ahead and click there. The first menu item in the global navigation bar is the Dashboard, which will give you a quick at-a-glance information for your site. If you didn't log into OU Campus using a direct edit link, which is still possible, the system would drop you off here. As you can see, I've got some dashboard gadgets that give me information about my account, from inbox messages to general site activity and a lot of things in between. I can choose which dashboard gadgets I have shown by clicking Configure Dashboard on the right-hand side. Also underneath the dashboard menu, in the global navigation bar, is the workflow screen, which will give me information about files I've sent to other users or files that they've sent to me, and the inbox, which is where I can send and receive messages to other users inside OU Campus. Now, moving on to the content menu, most users will spend the majority of their time here. The first thing in content is called Pages. When we click it, we're taken to the Pages list view, which gives us the file structure of the site. Obviously, there's a lot going on here in this view, and we won't cover all of it in this video, but the Pages list view is where you can make new pages and directories, upload other files, and edit the pages that are already in the site. You can also use Quick Search to search the content of your pages, just like a regular search engine, and use the Pages list view breadcrumb to get around the file structure. Now, down at the bottom of my screen, there's one more feature I want to make sure I mention. Anytime that there's a list view in OU Campus, and there are lots of places where there is one, you have the ability to control how many list items are shown on one screen before things start paginating. This is controlled down here, where you can adjust the number of items shown at one time, and also navigate between pages, if there are any pages in the pagination. So that's enough of the pages list view for now. The next option under content, if we go back up to the global navigation bar, is assets. Assets are a type of reusable content, and this screen is where they're created and managed. Now, these are the only two items that I have in the content menu right now, but that's due to my user level. Higher level users, like administrators, will have access to more menu options inside of content, but for the basics, really all you need to know is pages and assets. If you have the ability to delete files, which my user currently doesn't, I would also see the recycle bin underneath the content menu. But before we really move on, I want to take the time and point out two more icons that you may have noticed on the screen. One of them is a folder icon in the top left, and another is this plug icon in the top right. The folder icon is what we call the file navigation sidebar, and it's essentially the page's list view, but presented in a more standard hierarchical format, without as many extra tools as in the normal view. This is a great way to navigate quickly around your site, and it's always available on screen no matter where I am in OU campus. I can also view my assets from this sidebar as well. Now over to the right-hand side, we have our gadget sidebar. Gadgets are small, self-contained apps that do a host of neat functions in OU campus. Some of them are on the dashboard, as we already saw, but most of the gadgets in the system will live in this sidebar. Describing each one in detail would be too long for this video, but I highly recommend checking out the documentation on our support site to read up on all of our gadgets and where they can be used. What's cool is that the items that show up here are context-specific, meaning that certain gadgets can only be used when I'm viewing a certain screen in the system. If a gadget can't be used, it won't show up in the sidebar. I can always configure which gadgets are available by clicking the gear icon that's right next to Gadgets up at the top. So, moving on, the Reports menu in the global navigation bar is where you can run some reports to gather data across the entire site. Once again, I don't have full access to all of the reports in OU campus due to my not being an admin, but I can still get some pretty useful information from them. The last option in the global navigation bar, kind of on the left-hand side, is the Add-Ons menu, which are essentially bookmarks that have been added into the system. For example, I've got a handy link to an SEO cheat sheet here, so if I need to remind myself of best practices for SEO, I have easy access to it from inside the system so I can reference it quickly while I'm editing pages. Now that we've covered most of OU Campus's basics in terms of functionality, on the right-hand side of the global navigation bar, we do have two more quick menus. The first one, with my name on it, is where I can view and edit my user settings, such as external email address, phone number, time zone, and I can also click logout. Finally, to the right of that, we have our help menu, which has a few handy links. Firstly, we have a link to our support site. Secondly, there's a link to the OCN. Third, we have a link to our feedback forum, where you can suggest improvements to the product and vote on other suggestions. And finally, we have release notes, which you can view right inside of OU Campus. That about covers the key portions of the interface. Just as a final reminder, let's review the most important areas that we covered today. So up top, we have the global navigation bar and the global breadcrumb. Clicking content will bring us to the pages list view. We can open the file navigation sidebar on the left-hand side of the screen. And we also have the gadget sidebar on the other side. Finally, if you're viewing a page, we have the Page Actions toolbar near the top of the screen. Now go out there and explore the interface. In the videos to come, we'll dive deeper into the system and show you how to perform all of the essential end-user activities in OU Campus. Thanks for watching!